what genes are, what alleles are, what histones are, and type of histones, what are on and histones, what are mutations, and DNA mutation, and some type of mutation, and further some mutations. First, we are going to discuss the basic history of genes, which is for the first time, definition of gene was given in 1860 to 1900 by Gregor John Mendel as a gene as a discrete unit of identity. In 1866, George Mendel laid a foundation of modern genetics with his landmark study of heredity in garden tea plants. Though he did not speak of gene, he named it as a factor. The word gene was not coined until the year 2000, to the 20th century by Dennis Watson and William Johnson in 1909. The definition in 1900 to 2000 was: a gene is a segment that contributes to phenotype function. In the absence of demonstration function, a gene may be characterized by sequence, transcription of transcription or homologue. This was defined by Human Genome Nomenclature Organization. And for modern generation, for nowadays, gene is known to be as. The gene is considered to be as the basic unit of heredity. Genes are passed from generation to offspring to generation and contain information needed to specify physical and biological trait. Most gene code for specific protein, segment of protein, and having a different function in different bodies. Every person has two copies of gene, which is known to be as alleles. So let's see what alleles are. Alleles are, the word allele is a short form of allelomorph, which is known to be as other form. And allele is a gradient of gene. One or two or more possible form of gene that are found to be on the same place of chromosome. The allele occupies same specific region on the chromosome called locus. As you can see here, these are the homologous pairs of chromosomes. In which the gene is located on the same place of homologous chromosome, which one gene is code for the blue eye color and another is code for brown eye color. This is known to be an allele. The examples we can see here are the eye colors. Next, we are going to be seeing what are dominant genes and what are recessive genes. Dominant genes are genes that prevents the other genes from showing, is known to be as dominant. And the gene that does not show, even though it is present, is known to be as recessive. The basic example can be seen as a hitchhiker thumb, in which the straight thumb is dominant one and the hitchhiker thumb is the recessive one. The hitchhiker thumb is basically a genetic trait which is a recessive trait, and the hitchhiker thumb causes due to distal joint is responsible for making the thumb straight. When the distal joint hyperextend, it causes the thumb to extend backwards, which causes the hitchhiker thumb. And it is called hitchhiker thumb because it looks like when your thumb is given, you are hitching for a bike on the road. That is why it is called hitchhiker thumb. And it's medically known as distal joint hyperextensibility. So this was the example for dominant and recessive genes. Now further, we are going to see some familiar terms which are cistron, recon, and mutron. Samuel Benzer was first given was coined this term. Cistron. First, we are going to look into cistron, which is the unit of function. Cistron is a DNA segment equivalent to a gene. It is smallest unit of gene, a genetic material which code for a single polypeptide and function as a transmitter of gene information, genetic information. Thus, saying a gene might consist of more than one cistron. Taking the following example, say a mutation takes place in the chromosome position number 8, which is responsible for the change in recessive trait in a diploid organism. We see that the mutation is recessive unless both chromosomes of pair having the same mutation trait will not be expressed. Suppose a mutation is taking place on another position B, which is responsible for the same recessive trait, then position A and B are said to be on same cistron. And further, cistrons are divided into basically two categories, which is monocistronic and polycistronic, in which monocistronic means one cistron in a transcription unit, that is, it contains only one gene segment, as you can see here, which code for only one type of amino acid of protein. While in polycistronic, we can see that it is described as a situation in which two or three or more separate proteins are encoded in a single mRNA, which you can see here. There are different types of protein which is coded by a single mRNA. So it is called as polycistronic. Further, it is recon, which is the unit of recombination. Smallest segment of DNA, which is capable to undergo recombination. A recon consists of more than two pair of nucleotide. There may be more than one recon in the system. And other nucleon, which is the unit of mutation. Smallest segment of genetic material that undergo mutation. When a unit is changed, may show phenotypic trait. So strong neutron and recon are the unit in descending order, which means a gene consists of several cistrons, a cistron of several recon, and recon of several neutrons. Since we are talking about mutons, we are going to see further look into mutation. What is mutation? So, this Hugo de Vries was the first to term the name mutation. Among the group of species, Ornithera limarckiana is a species of evening primrose, grow bilaterally with abandoned protactophylline. Taking seed of these, he found that they produce many new variants in his experimental garden and introduced the term mutation. So he further explained what mutation is, and he stated that the mutation is a change in the DNA sequence of organism. Mutation can result from errors in DNA replication during cell division, exposure to mutagen, or viral infections. Germline mutation can be passed on to the offspring, while somatic mutation are not passed on. So we are going to look into the type of mutation here. This is the DNA mutation, which is protein DNA sequence. These are the protein sequences which code for mRNA and other proteins. If the mutation happens in the coding region, they create a white box region in which we can specifically alter a sequence and detect it further what DNA changes are being made. And it is known for basically we are going to do this because we are going to detect if there is a change in the DNA sequence or not. And non-DNA coding gene mutation are those regions which do not code for any protein. And if the mutation happens there, it might be responsible for making a protein which was not supposed to be there. At the wrong place at the wrong time, we can say. So these are coding gene mutation and non-coding gene mutation. Further, there are several types of mutation in which we are going to see in the DNA level, at the protein level, and chromosome mutation. We are going to look into them in one by one very quickly. First type of mutation is deletion. In deletion, where there is a loss of segment of gene in the DNA sequence, which causes the deletion. And a great example for it is Creutzfeldt-Jakob syndrome. And duplication, in which the DNA segment is getting duplicated or repeated, which makes it a duplicate. And a further example of it is Mellitus syndrome. And inversion happens when the DNA sequence is break off and get joined together by in a reverse manner, and it causes the inversion. And in insertion, we can see a different chromosome number 4 get detached from its chromosome and get attached to another chromosome and causes insertion. And in translocation, the two different DNA segments from a chromosome get translocated, or we can say interchanged to each other, which causes translocation. Further, there are silent mutation, silent mutation, nonsense mutation, and missense mutation. This is the segment where no mutation is happening. This is PTC at the DNA level, which get encoded in mRNA like AAG and coded for amino acid lysine. And in silent mutation, we can see a single nucleotide change is happening. In the case of C, it is exchanged by D, but the amino acid is same, it is still lysine, which means the silent mutation may alter the DNA sequence, but it does not affect the amino acids. It does not change the amino acid sequence, hence it is called silent. It is there, but it is silent. Its expression is silent. Nonsense mutation, if we can say, it will stop the protein formation, or we can say it stops the translation process if the mutation happens. And in missense mutation, as the name suggests, it is a mistake in the sequence which changes the amino acid sequence. As you can see, this is lysine, and after the missense mutation, there is arginine in that case. And missense mutation are a further two types, conservative and non-conservative, which means conservative, is we can say, it replaces for example, in Down syndrome, there is a single chromosome which is doubled in at position 21, and in Turner syndrome, there is an absence. So we can say failure of chromosomes to separate during mitosis may cause the baby to have too many or too few chromosomes, which is known to be as heterozygous. And further, we can say mutagen is the last play. Mutagen, anything that causes mutation is known to be as mutagen, and there may be physical mutagen, chemical mutagen.